Okay, so in this video, we're going to look at adding music in Filmora X. Now, first off, I'm going to show you how to add the ones included in Film Stock and Filmora X. Then I'm going to show you how to add one from your files. So first off, the ones built into Filmora and Film Stock. Now, Film Stock is basically Filmora's subscription. Personally, we don't really use it because we use Envato Elements for our music. You also get 124 tracks included in your Filmora. So you can just click on these and then double click. And that will start playing your music. So you can just go through these and pick out which one you like. You can also use the ones on the side to tell you what kind of music it is. So if we wanted a young and bright song, and maybe this, Friends on the Way. So we're just gonna drag this onto our audio track. And you can see this has added it here. Now what you may realize is that when adding this, now if I pressed play, now you can't hear Adrian speaking. So what we're gonna do, just gonna come down through this, grab this line, you'll see the cursor's changed, and we're just gonna bring it down. You can also double click on this, and then we'll press play, and we'll just adjust it so we can hear Adrian, and also slightly hear the music. Okay, so we've not actually set our video's audio levels, so these are peaking quite a bit. Minus 30 has worked well for our music. So you don't want this loud enough that it'll distract people, but just loud enough so people can tell it's there. I'd always recommend for background music to use songs that don't have any vocals, as having multiple voices at the same time can really distract someone. But another thing you can do is maybe at this point we're showing something and it's not really anything that you need to be able to hear us. So if we pretend that Adrian was muted at this point, then what we can do is we can make sure we're selected on this and we can click over here and this will add an audio keyframe. So if we assume that this part of the clip is now where Adrian comes back and starts talking again, then we're gonna click to add another keyframe and then in between these, we're gonna say 5 frames. This is completely up to you of how much you want to fade it in and out. So 5 frames in and then we're gonna click to add a keyframe. And we're gonna go on to this one and do 5 frames back in. So, okay, so now you can see we've got our 4 keyframes and what we're going to do is we're just gonna bring this up.
So hi, this is Future Owen and I just wanted to say that there's a much easier way to do this. If when you've got these 4 keyframes, you just drag up or down in the middle, depending on if you're turning it up or down, this will make your life a whole lot easier. Just thought I'd save you some time and have a good time with the rest of the video.
And we're gonna bring ours to about minus 18. This isn't necessarily something we've heard. This is just a kind of eyeball of just to show you that this is turning it up. So we're gonna see that this is minus 18.6 and we don't really want it to change in between here. So we're gonna change that to minus 18.6. And now this has just made a nice ramp up, which has just turned up the volume in that and turned it back down. For a length as short as this one, it's probably not worth doing, but if this was for a long section, then you could do this. You could also select these keyframes and move them along, and this has just lengthened that out, but it has also changed the volume. So I'd recommend double checking and making sure these are set right. Remember to press enter for this to keep that set. And now we've just turned up the volume and turned it back down. To remove these keyframes, you just want to go over the keyframe and click the same button you pressed to add them. Make sure to do this on both the inside ones and then the outside ones, because if you do this on the outside ones first, it will just keep that level. So it will be turned up for the rest of your video. So maybe this song isn't what we want. Usually we wouldn't necessarily use these stock ones, so we can just remove that. And if we bring over Envato Elements, I've already got it set on the music, and now we can use this to find our music. If you don't have Envato Elements or something like this, there'll be a link in the description where you can sign up to it. So I'm just gonna try and find a song that we think works. Okay, so I've just found some basic background music, so I'm just downloading it now. So I've now just grabbed that music and I'm just gonna put it in my media. I'm gonna make a new folder and call it music. And then I'm just gonna drop this in here. And now we've got our background music and we can just drop this in the exact same audio track. And then just like how we showed in the other one, you can control this by either dragging that or moving it here. So this one, because it's a different track, is actually quite a bit quieter. So we are going to turn it up a bit. Okay, that works well for this. So you can just hear it, but it's not loud enough to be distracting. Just two things I would say about this is, first off, remember that this music doesn't necessarily fit to the whole video. So we will need to either add a new music track or add this one again and just kind of do what we can to make it not obvious that one's ended and one's started. But you can usually do this by finding similar parts in the start and end of the song and just kind of fading these between them, which you can do with the keyframes that we've shown you. Another thing to remember is that if you are just adding it in afterwards, like I've just done on here, remember to make sure that it's not flowing over by this much. Because now, for me, this is the end of my video and you can see I've still got a long time left before this music ends. So what we can do is we can just cut it like a video. But I'm going to delete that for now, because for this kind of video, we don't necessarily want music on it. So I hope that was useful. If it was, please leave a like and remember to subscribe. There'll be a link to Envato Elements in the description. Remember, this is an affiliate link, so if you buy it through that, it will give a commission. But yeah, so thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you next time.